software by hand all the time, so that was to talk just before this one about having your preferences stored somewhere and then you get them automatically configured on the desktop you are using without having to ask for it. You just press something and then everything is working nicely for you. So it should be available already on all systems. So to talk about free software, text mode is generally quite well accessible because technically it's quite simple. But it's not so suited to beginners. Beginners don't really like text interfaces. GNOME is quite accessible. One issue we had was with GNOME 3, which was mostly a restart from the beginning. So it's digging back to the point it was with GNOME 2, but not so much. So that's really a concern to see this kind of regressions. And what's more concerning is that we are really late compared to the Windows world. They started like a couple of decades ago, while we have only started like a dozen years ago. And it does show up in the tests we can be doing. Compared to Apple, we are really at Stone Age. The Apple screen readers are really great. And they are integrated. You take whatever Apple product, you just have to know some shortcut, you learn by heart, it works on all Apple products. And it does really work nice, so much that some people who were really strong free software believers have switched to Apple, just because otherwise they wouldn't be able to do computing. And that's really a concern we have to deal with. A bit of technology, so the way it works is that we have the application here, which has an abstract representation of the widgets, windows, etc. And then it is rendered visually. And what happens is that we have an accessibility bus, which will actually discuss with that abstract representation to get the information, the text, how it is related and together, etc. And then we have the screen reader, which is able to get that information through the bus and render that to an accessibility device. A play device, speech synthesis, something else, we don't have to care. The idea is that as long as the abstract representation provides all the information in a good way, then the screen reader will do its work. And so for instance, we have here gedit, which uses GTK and renders things through Pango to the X server, but it also has ATK to let Orca, the screen reader, access the text and then render this as great speech, etc. So how it works is basically that Orca asks for the text and also gedit notifies Orca when text changes. So that's how it looks like from a screen reader perspective. So you have the main window, which may have a vertical container, and then you have a menu bar with menu items, and then you have a horizontal container with a text area, an OK button, and so the screen reader has access to the tree of widgets. So it can work quite well, and it does so, well, the console is just text, for graphical applications. It does work really well with GTK 2 and 3. Qt 4 was not so good. They mostly have left it as it is. Qt 5 is being worked on and it's really improving. We have Java also working. Acrobat, Adobe did implement some accessibility in the reader. So it does, it did work at least. I haven't tested lately. A lot of other applications are not. So notably old Qt applications, the venerable XT applications, and also of course all the applications which render their output directly. So XPDF is not accessible at all. In practice, it's not just because you have your application in GTK that it is accessible. Because for instance here, we have a dialog box with first name, full, last name, bar, etc. But if it is programmed this way, that is, we have the first column with label, first name, label, last name, label, class one, and then the second column, label, text, full, text, bar, text, pass, you don't remember which one is which. is who or are the first name, last name, I don't know. And so it's really not usable. Even if technically it is accessible, in practice it's not usable. And so you would much better use label first name for text. So you make a relation between the label and the text, and then you have put the semantic into your application, and so the screen reader can work. In case you have not done your work, what happens in practice is that in the screen reader, we would implement a script that takes that information and knows that, okay, they are related together, I know that, and so I put them together. And this is what we would like to avoid, not have to write scripts in the screen reader, because of course, as soon as you add something in your application, then the script is outdated and it doesn't work anymore. So you really need to do things logically. So that's the idea. Don't try to make your applications accessible. Just make accessible applications from the start. And quite often it's just common sense. Well, of course, it doesn't mean you shouldn't fix your existing applications, but keep thinking about it. Which way of thinking I have to keep to make things accessible from the start. For text applications, there are just a couple of things. So text really works great. So if you have something implemented, make a library so that you can have both a graphical and a text interface for it. And for text, do put the cursor where it does matter, so that the screen reader will know that this is where the user should look at. For graphical applications, ideally, you would design your application without thinking about graphics, without thinking about rendering. Just make it logical, just like CSS things. And use standard widgets. So as I said, use a label text field instead of a label and a text field. Avoid homemade widgets, because then they will not be accessible, or you implement accessibility for them. And always provide alternative textual content when you have, for instance, a picture or something like this. And of course, keep it simple. That will be useful not only for accessibility, but also for all your users. A couple of traps. You shouldn't have to use the mouse. You shouldn't have to use the keyboard. You shouldn't have to use anything. You should be able to do everything with all kinds of input. Of course, take care of contrasts. Make colors configurable. That's one thing. Make things configurable in general, so that the user can tune the way he prefers. Avoid timing-based things. People have the need for time to understand what's happening, so don't make time things. Do not organize with 2D things. Just organize logically, and it can work. Just a couple of tools. For text mode, you have braille.freecat.org, which provides a tutorial for this. There is documentation on the same website. You can test yourself with Orca. You can enable a braille monitor so you can see what is actually showing up on a braille device. Of course, you can crash test. You turn on speech and then try to use your application, and then you will see that it's really hard. Accessizer shows you the tree as the screen reader sees it, so that you can check that everything shows up, all the information. About perks, you will read about it later, it's a bit long to explain. To conclude, accessibility is really a concern for a lot of people. 10% people would say that they have major concerns, but 20% would say, some of the things I cannot do because I cannot. And they would not consider themselves handicapped, but still, some things they wouldn't do. Quite often it's just a question of common sense. Do things logically, simple, configurable, and then it will be nice for everybody, not only people who have disabilities, but also your regular users. We just need to raise awareness of this so that everybody thinks about it all the time. Thanks.
Question? Yes. Yeah, I'd like to say, well, I have several ourselves, and what you often see is, so palsy certainly, because it's a motorical handicap within the brain, everything is different, and you have special centers where they're specialized in making accessibility tools for handicap, but they always have to first see the patient, because they always have to implement it for the patient in specific, because they have specific needs by themselves.
I'm not sure to understand the question, but you're saying that in some cases you have to make specific applications because the needs are very specific.
It's really expensive, by the way, also, because often you have to make explicitly specific accessibility tools for that patient in specific.
So you say in some cases you have to make something specific for one person?
Yeah, and in both cases actually.
Yes, ideally your software is configurable enough so that yes, you have to tune it for one person, but at least you can do it. And for me, it's actually quite of a new job for practitioners, the physicians, to say, okay, I know that this software exists. I will take this one for you and adapt it for your needs.
Mm-hmm.
For me, that's perhaps some kind of new jobs, yes. But at least they won't have to deal with the code, and it's much easier to get people doing it. That's the way I see it. Of course, in some cases, you will have to use dedicated software, because even if the software is configurable, you cannot get up to the task of making it usable for that person. And then, yeah, it's expensive. But at least for 99.99 people, maybe we can have it that way with configuration.
Maybe one more question, just to give us some time to overlap. Any more questions?
Yeah. Wouldn't supporting softwares would be the better answer? You mean that those screen readers and stuff, for example, for images, there are AI solutions that learn, you know, that what does the image contain, and not, you know, every designer filling out the metadata that what is it on the picture.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear everything.
Okay.
But it's just a question of loudness. Please speak loud.
Okay. Wouldn't supporting softwares would be the better answer that are already existing for them? You know, screen reading and stuff.
For whom?
For, you know, there are screen readers for, you know, blind people that reads a lot of text on the page already. And there could be AI solutions to, you know, identify the images, so that, you know, not every developer have to design this way, but we make better support software for them.
I'm not sure to understand the question. You're saying that perhaps we could make artificial intelligences which are able to understand the software so that the person can use it?
So you mean something like if there's a...
I think we don't have enough time for further, but or to continue the question, because we need to switch from here.
We just say, even with that case, it's really difficult. So I don't see it more easy with artificial intelligence.